Hi, this is Daisy Dai, and I am here with Pacific Magazine and Berkeley Film Friends, and we are here on the press line for the Hollars.
There's something about shooting independent film that is very difficult, and there's a whole lot of hurdles that you have to overcome, which I think is such a great teaching tool to really hold the mirror up to yourself and say, is this really what you want? Do you love it enough? And I think that's the advice I'd give any filmmaker who's doing independent film, for sure, is you got to love it enough because it's difficult. It's hard to do. Listen, making any movie is very difficult. But I think it's also one of those things that because it's so hard, it's also much more bonding. You know, a lot of these smaller movies, you have to find wherever you can. You know, you have to make every dollar count. And I think in doing that, you get people who are all down there for the right reasons. They just want to make a good film. And so it teaches you a lot about how to take all that goodwill and put it towards the next thing you do.
So we are college students from UC Berkeley, and we're trying to break into the film industry. And we're just curious, what do you consider your first big break, and how did you get there?
Oh, man, that's a great question. So many different ones. I did a bunch of weird commercials, one of which I shaved a reverse mohawk into my head. Don't recommend doing that. I'd say the biggest, what I remember is one of my biggest first experiences was doing the movie Kinsey, and I had a tiny part in it, but it was a really fun, important part of the movie as far as storytelling-wise. And for me, it was hugely important because I got to work with the amazing Bill Condon and watch, you know, Liam do his thing, and it was just something where I felt like I was a part of something important and big. And it was that first feeling of, like, I didn't want to screw it up. And I remember, the truth is, I was rehearsing my lines with Liam Neeson in the trailer. Everything was going fine. And then I got in front of the camera for the first time. I think it was my first movie. There was nothing behind my words. I was just saying words. And I remember Liam Neeson came over, and he was the one who said, "What are you doing?" I said, "What are you talking about?" And he was like, "Oh, when we were back in the trailer, you're doing great." And it was that first moment of, the best work is always going to be what comes from your heart. And when you believe it and you love it, that's what's going to come out and be good. The moment you overthink it and you're trying to do something for somebody else, it'll never be the right thing.
And what about this script drew you to the Hollars?
This script was, I attached myself as an actor like 5 or 6 years ago, actually. I wasn't going to direct it. And then they, like many movies, couldn't get their financing. So they asked me to buy the script if I wanted to and make it on my own. And you know, that's really scary. There's money involved and also a whole lot of, you know, scary uphill challenges. But at the same time, it was one of those things where I wanted to take it on for the experience. And this movie was something that was worth doing. I think family is so important to me. And I'm lucky enough to come from a really close-knit family. But even still, the fact that this family is dysfunctional, I still read the script and I was like, oh my God, my family's in there somewhere. And I hope everybody feels that way.
Would you do it again if you could?
100%. Have to. Yeah. These are always way the better experiences.
Wonderful. Thank you so
much. Absolutely. Yeah. Good luck to you guys. Yeah.